Hello and welcome to the second part of the character modeling tutorial. I will dive right into it. First, we will start with the feet. Go to the end of the shin where we stopped and select the five vertices on the front side. Extrude, shaping the form of the foot but without the toes. Don't add more extrusions than necessary. We need to keep the circulation synchronized with the rest of the body. Then select the 5 vertices on the back side and shape it to the form of the ankle. Then connect both sides together. Now make a face on the side of the foot on both the outer and inner sides. Make sure that the circulation of the mesh is done smoothly. Add or remove an edge loop if needed to make sure it's distributed evenly. Now that the foot blocking act is complete, just start shaping it to be the same as the reference, and smoothing out the form a bit in the process. Now we will start doing the toes. First, add two edges on the front side of the foot and triangle it at the top. Then do the same to the back side corresponding to the ones done on the front. Start extruding the toes one by one with size in mind. Once you are done extruding the toes, just smoothen out the form of the foot, and if you want to add more detail to the toes, just add more edge loops. It won't affect the rest of the mesh as the toe structure is separated from the rest of the body, which was done intentionally to be able to add details on those parts in particular without affecting the rest of the body. If the faces look weird, then make sure that the normals are all facing the same direction. Once you are satisfied with the feet, go for the hands. The steps will be about the same, with only little differences. Start by blocking out the wrist and the palm of the hand. Then divide the face into 4 sections that will become the fingers. Extrude a little part on the side of the hand, which will be the thumb. inset the four sections that roots the fingers to make a gap between the fingers. Then start extruding the fingers. Keep in mind that the extrusion should be divided almost equally. Now start rotating them. My tip here would be, if you want to keep definition on of the fingers, especially at the joints when they are bending, then do them in a bent pose from the get-go. And keep an adequate distance between fingers for faster weight painting, which will be done in the future. Now, I will be showing on the hands how we add detail to the fingers, because it's a little bit trickier than the toes. If you ain't careful, you'll find yourself adding too many edge loops, which is something we want to avoid. For a low mid pulley hand, I would say this is a perfect hand and has potential for adding even more detail without adding too many edge loops. Okay, now that the hardest part is over, let's do something more enjoyable. We will block out the butt. First off, delete the faces that will have the butt cheeks, but leave the faces in the middle for the crack. And add two horizontal edge loops on those faces we left out. Then remake a face instead of the ones we deleted and start insetting it a couple of times, but make sure it's smoothing out while insetting and not overlapping. It should be making like a heart shape or two oval like shapes depending on how you proceeded until this point, but either ways it's fine as long as it has like a circular shape. When you start connecting the vertices, try your hardest to keep them in quad shapes. So yeah, that's it for the bot, the rest is just smoothing out and refining. Lastly, on this part of the tutorial is a little bonus. It will be the belly button and the breasts. I don't see it necessary to add edge loops for the belly button, to be honest. So I just insert the section that I want it to be in. But I will knife out the inset because I'm using the mirror modifier. So yeah, just redo that once more, then push those faces deeper. There, you have the belly button done in no time. Now that that's out of the way, let's do the breasts. Just like the bot area, we will delete the area that will be formed out, but this time we will use the loop tools add-on to circle that area before inserting it. And we will just form it with every inset. Shaping this with the right proportions is actually very important because it greatly impacts the chest area, curves and structure. If not done right, something will always look off on the front and side views specifically. And the light impact on what's above and below that will be showing in a strange looking way, and it will have some sort of and a realistic volume to it. So yeah, that was it for this part of the tutorial. That now makes a complete body. In the next part, I will be showing you how to do the head really quickly. And there will be some tricks there. I hope you all found this part useful. I'm sorry it took longer than usual. There won't be as much delays for the next videos. So don't forget to like and subscribe and check my other videos. Thank you all, and until next video.